This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there once again. Welcome to episode 52. In this episode, I'm going to show you a couple of more basic logarithm problems and show you how to evaluate some of the more straightforward problems that you'll see. Let's start off. All right, the first problem I'll give you is to evaluate the logarithm log 464. Let me just label the parts of the logarithm for you. The little number underneath the log is called the base. And the number that you are taking the logarithm of is called the argument. In order to evaluate this log, the first thing you must understand is that the log is the inverse of an exponential. What this means is that you can use an exponential to get rid of the log and maybe make a little better sense out of all this. However, the exponential that you use has to match the base of the logarithm. All right, so if we're going to do anything about this, we're going to start with the log base 4 of 64 equals x. And our base is the number at the bottom, that's 4. So we're going to use a 4 exponential. So we'll say 4 on the left raised to the log base 4 of 64 equals 4 raised to the x. Now, since the 4 exponential and the log base 4 are inverses, they both cancel out, leaving you with just 64 on the left. On the right, we now have 4 raised to the x power. Now imagine what would happen if we put x equals 1 in there. If we said x equals 1, then 4 would be raised to the first power, which would just give you 4. That does not match the left side. We'd rather have 64. Let's try 2. So we would have 4 squared on the right hand side, but 4 squared is 16. That doesn't match the right answer because we're still looking for 64. Let's try 3. We would have 4 raised to the third power. 4 raised to the third power is 64. Therefore, x equals 3, and we can say that log base 4 of 64 is simply 3. What we have here is called log form. In order to change to exponential form, we would simply use our 4 exponential on both sides. We would have 4 raised to the log base 4 of 64 equals 4 raised to the third. We simply stick a 4 underneath both sides. But since 4 and log base 4 are inverses of each other, they both cancel out, and you'll have 64 equals 4 to the third, which is what we just found over here. All right, armed with the knowledge of how we can rewrite logs, let's try something a little bit more complicated. All right, this time we have to evaluate this logarithmic expression, log base 4 of 16 plus log 100. This is referred to as common log because there's no base written below it. Plus this other one called ln of e to the third. This is called natural log So we have three different types of logs here, and I'll go through how to operate on each of them. Let's have a look at our first term. We have log base 4 of 16, and we want to try to find what that equals. What this is saying is that 4 raised to some power equals 16. So we can think of this as saying 4 raised to something is equal to 16. We saw in our previous example that in order to get to 16, the x would have to be 2. Therefore, this entire piece is simply 2, because the power you would use to make 16 out of 4 is second power. And that's all we have to do for the first term. Now what about this common log here? We don't have a base written. Common log without the base written is actually meant to be a base 10 log. So you could also write it as log with a 10 underneath of 100. What that means is that 10 raised to some power equals 100. Okay? Or if you prefer, in exponential form, 10 raised to the x equals 100. But you might realize that in order to get 100, we'd have to take 10 to the second power, so that this middle term is also 2. Now for the third term, natural log, or ln, you might hear it called. The natural log is a base lowercase e log. So it could also be written as log base e of e to the third. If you haven't seen e before, e is a little bit like pi in that it's an irrational number and can't really be represented with a decimal. It's enough to know that that's about 2.7, or thereabouts. Don't worry, you can always write e on your paper. Your instructor will know what you mean. Now, recall that the log and the exponential are inverses of each other. They're both base e in the log and the exponential, so they both cancel out. And look at the only thing left is 3. So our expression simplifies all the way down to 2 plus 2 plus 3, and so our answer is just 7. And that is how you can simplify a complicated looking log expression into something fairly simple. Just rewrite it in exponential form. And remember that your laws of inverses still apply here. If you take the inverse of a function and operate it on the function, it cancels out and gives you something fairly nice at the end. All right, thank you for watching. We'll see you again next episode.